Hey everybody, this is One Girl, Two Guys. Unfortunately, our third co-host, she's not here. In spirit, she's here, but she's just not here today. Stay tuned for next week. She'll be back. We're just going to give you a little taste of what's going on, what to look forward to. I am Mr. Hamilton.
I am the one and only BG, and this is a spinoff of the BG Show. This show is basically going to be about real life issues and things that's going on in entertainment, things that's going on in the community, things that's just going on in the world. We are going to give it to you real, boy, and uncut. You know what I'm saying? Like, really, 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 really real. Nasty. So let's get into first. Let's talk about Brian, these down low motherfuckers.
That's sick.
I mean, the book was out. First of all, did you read the book?
No.
You didn't read the book?
I'm
you're a reader. I'm surprised because you're a reader. Brian has so many books. Like, you read.
I didn't read it, but I know about the download guys, so I'm pretty sure.
Have you ever messed with them?
Plenty.
I did too, but I don't like them. I don't. They're dangerous creatures.
I actually, as crazy as this might be, I actually like download guys. It's less of a headache. You know, it's more fun. I don't have to deal with you like that. It's no emotions. It's just, it's easier. It's less complicated.
Well, let's explain why. Oh, you're saying it's basically download. It's easier, but download brother actually can't be easy because you can't run to the movies with them. You can't, like, you can't be walking in the street with them like that. Well, it depends what download you're messing with.
That, and it also depends on who you are. It's nothing for me to kick it out in the public with the download guy. It's been plenty of times where it has happened. That's why it's easy.
In a small city like this, Cincinnati, you can be rolling around with a download brother. You must be going to Mason.
Really?
I love Mason, by the way. Shout out to all the Mason people.
They're not shouting out back. But, yes, you know, it depends. It depends. But I think it's easier to mess with the download guy because, honestly, I just want to have fun. I just want to kick it. They're not worried about who I'm dealing with, and I'm not worried about who they're dealing with. I'm not saying it's right. It is disrespectful. It does have it's boundary lines, and I'm with it, but I'm not with it. I'm with it when I just want to have fun. I want to kick it. It's not a headache. We being at the end of the day, let's just chill. That's it.
I told you.
It doesn't have to always be about sex. It's not always.
But that's what they want. Basically.
That don't mean you gotta give to them.
Okay, so what about the one, would you deal with one if you had a baby mother? Like, you know, if he had a baby mother with kids and still with his baby mother, like, fucking her, can you still fuck with him too?
No.
Have you ever did it?
Yes. Not consciously knowing that he had one and they were current. You know how it always go, yeah, I got my baby mom, but you know, we going through some, you know, that bullshit. As soon as I hear it, I don't have nothing. I think it's disrespectful because to me and her, for one, I can know about her, but she can't know about me.
Right.
I am nobody's secret. I don't like it. That's why I said I'm with the download thing, but I'm not with it because I have respect for myself as an individual. But I don't believe in messing with married men. I do not believe in messing with men that still are with women and they live in a lifestyle with the white pickets and all of that. That's just, now that's raunchy and, you know, just tacky within itself. I don't do that.
I just think it's disrespectful, and we're going to jump into the next topic, but I just have to say this. I think it's disrespectful.
Have you messed with the download guy?
I have not, because I don't like it. It's just disrespectful.
Are you sure?
I'm sure. I don't like faggots either, though. Like, I can't say, you know, playing with faggots.
That's a harsh word.
No, well,
okay.
I don't wanna flame a queen. Is
okay, that better? That's much better.
I'm glad I have Brian here to correct you, because you know I get bashed on my tongue sometimes.
That was real.
Thank you.
I really don't like that word.
You don't like the word?
I've never been called it, but I don't like it.
You don't like it?
I don't, it's and what people really need to understand, a faggot is a cigarette, it's a German word.
Ooh.
So yes, I'm very educated after that. I think.
Well, like, okay, so basically, I think it's just disgusting when they can suck on your cock and then they can go kiss their baby mother and eat her. Like, I just think it's disrespectful to the. And that's why most girls, if you get into it, it don't be naked, disrespected. That's on the street. Usually, like, I don't get spooked and, or, you know, guys, you know.
And you know, it's
the women be so mad at the gay guys.
And we really on y'all's side.
We on your team.
Sit back. Let us teach you something. No, but you know what's crazy is,
And I think that's about to be the next topic, is the gay guys that get upset by the down low guys who see them out, and then they want to put them out. An actual transgender here.
Something in Ohio. That's what we are.
That's unfortunate. Oops. Didn't mean to say that. Didn't mean it. But she outed him in front of his family, all of that, and then he dropped the family off and came back and murdered him. And it's unfortunate, it's sad. That's how the cookie crumbled. I don't wish that upon nobody, but you know what you're getting yourself into, dealing with an individual like that. So the fact that you can't catch feelings when you're dealing with a person like that, and I believe that individual caught feelings, and they were feeling disrespected, and they felt the need to out them. And he was not about that. And unfortunately, I can't think of, I'm not even gonna say his name. People know who it is. I'm not even going to, because I'm just not gonna do that. I'm not gonna say his name. But people know who it is. And it's like I said, I'm saying it again, it's unfortunate, and I wish it didn't happen.
Next topic, Hampton. Oh, that's his name on the show, Hampton.
Yes.
Next topic. Abandoned daddies.
Abandoned down low daddies.
Now let's get into that.
Yes.
But let's get into the females first. That, you know, they get pregnant. Well, let me just say this to y'all girls out here. Wait.
Okay.
Y'all be 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, whatever the age. And y'all be so in love. Y'all want to get knocked up and have this baby and all this. And knowing that there's something, it'd be crazy because the nigga sometimes don't even want to be with you for real. He'd be like, yo, let's get this abortion. I paid for it. But you just, for them to say that? I think they're like, you know, right there, I'm not taking care of it. So let's get this taken care of now. It's unfortunate that we have to kill infant.
And I don't like that women do force that responsibility.
Yeah, and he gave you the opportunity to do what you have to do, do it.
If he says he doesn't want to have a baby with you, why want to have a baby with a nigga who don't want to have a baby?
Right.
Yeah, I want this baby because, you know, I'm a little baby.
My baby daddy. Like, why do you put yourself in a predicament so you can be...
But like, then again, I will say this.
They want the assistant. They want the government assistant. That must be what it is.
It ain't that much assistance.
They can get it. They can get Section 8. They can stamp.
It's not working. You still got to deal with a human being for 18 years. Okay, let me say this. We are men, so we really don't know. Unfortunately, the co-host isn't here. It is a woman. So she would have
the perfect. Anna Rose. That's her name. She would have it.
Unfortunately, she's not here. But I will say I have a cousin. She decided to have a baby. She just had it. Like, I'm going.
Keyword.
She just had it. I'm going to go have a baby. And I honestly, you're stupid. I'm just going to say it, cousin, and I think the bitch was dumb. I'm going to say this. And I'm upset at my aunt because they allowed this and they could have prevented this. And they just didn't do their job as a parent. And I just feel like at 15, 16, you don't know where you're going to be at 5, 10. Years down the line, you might not feel the same way you feel then now. So why make a decision like that? I just feel like that's too much of a serious situation to be like, you want to do this. I don't think your prefrontal cortex. I learned that. I know that. That's a real word. That means.
What does it mean since you know it?
That means your brain is not fully developed. It's developed, but it's not fully developed.
You mean.
Yeah, that's right.
I like that.
So yeah, that's true. You know, and I don't think they really understand what it really means to be a parent. Being a parent is being independent and not worried about the government, Section 8, food stamps. That shit ain't hot. My mom didn't raise me on no government assistance. I don't know anything about it. Down. I do have family members that do have government assistance.
Ain't nothing wrong with a stamp.
We done bought some food stamps. Don't get it twisted. We done got some food stamps. But
I'm just saying one yes on you. But
my mom
saying
that's on
your mind.
Yeah, but my mom also had me as a grown. My mom had me as a grown woman. So she lived her life, and then when she got grown, then that's when she decided to have a baby. But 15, 16, you don't know. I don't think it's appropriate. I think shit is a mess. I think it's not hot. It's not cute.
It's not cute at all.
It's very distasteful. And I just feel that you really don't get to live your life. Yeah, you might be like, it don't slow me down. It ain't gonna slow me. Shit, yes, the fuck it do. Let me tell you something. You don't get to do or have all the advantages. You don't have all the advantages as
to you don't have all the advantage. I'm just saying because in Cincinnati, you're from New York, which I'm pretty sure you done seen everything.
Oh yeah.
But in Cincinnati, it was kind of when I was coming up. Girls got pregnant at a young age, but it wasn't like that. Then, when I got into high school, I did start to notice and see, like, oh, this is what the hoes do. They have babies at 16. It's just, we fucking in high school, you know? And so, it's just,
well, I don't like the show Sweet 16. What is it? Is it called? No, not Sweet 16. No, the pregnant show on MTV.
Pregnant
show
16.
That show should be banned. I don't think that's cute at all. That's not, what you said, bro? That's not hot?
That's not hot.
That's not hot. That show is the disgrace to me. I don't like the way y'all promoting it. I really don't.
It's a reality show. People are gonna watch it. It's entertainment. Why not get some ratings? They get money for the ratings. A girl that wants to expose herself and her life drama while she's going pregnant. Honestly, what's kind of sad is, I think, oh,
don't come home.
I think young women are intentionally, some are getting pregnant just to have a spot on the show. You're not guaranteed a spot.
You're not, nope. But you know what? What I wanted to do, because this is a new show and we are going to have guests and interview them. So what I want you to do is if a person that, or in Cincinnati, we might get this, but if somebody out there that's watching this show that's a female, and you got pregnant at 16, I want to know how that changed your life.
I know a girl that got pregnant at 15. Did she do the show right now on
the phone? Well, no, I want to lie to you. I'm lying directly. But if you watching, comment, or if you don't want to be exposed, just comment and let us know how your life was changed. You know, what's different about your life.
Tell us the situation. A curse can be a blessing.
It could have slowed you down big time.
And you might have needed to be slowed down.
Yeah.
That might have been what saved your life from getting whatever.
Exactly. Next topic. Well, this is a bonus topic because we don't want to, you know, overjoin y'all on this first new show yet, but we got so much to come. We're going to try to drop the shows like every Wednesday for you guys.
Yes.
Every Wednesday. But this is the last question I want to ask you. I want to try to comment and, you know, tell me what y'all think, because I love y'all feedback. Also, tell me what y'all think about the new thing. One girl and two guys. But my last one was this. People in love. Do you believe?
Man, you're trying to be funny.
No, I'm not.
Man,
can you be in a relationship? Like, it's one, like, if me and Brian was in a relationship, can we be in a relationship with a third, like, another party?
Are you trying to be funny?
No, I just want to know what the people think.
Okay.
So on that note, that's the question I'm going to come back with y'all for next one.
A Stevie J situation.
Stevie J.
Because Mimi ain't the only one dealing with it, I'm just saying.
Ooh, shout out to Mimi. She was in Cincinnati. We had to get some of the top.
Don't do that.
So make sure you subscribe. Brian, what's your information they can follow you?
My name on Instagram is Bryant_Hampton_Curry. And on Facebook, my name is Mr. Hampton at his finest. Or if you want to email me, whatever, it's bcurry88@yahoo.com or bcurry846@gmail.com.
Oh, and he's a model if you want to book him.
An actor, you know, I'm just saying. And I also host events.
Yes.
We will be hosting
events. We will be hosting events. So if you want to come to your city and make it hot, email me at VickyGotti@yahoo.com. Follow me on Instagram, VickyGotti. Facebook, VickyGotti. You know the way.